Hi friends, welcome back to PSDESIRE Photoshop tutorials. In this video, I will show you how to use a simple Photoshop trick to add depth and dimensions to your model space. This trick uses method from makeup and cosmetics to create a visually pleasing and more three-dimensional look. So without any delay, let's get started. The first thing we need to do is select the pen tool, and you can do that by simply pressing the P key on your keyboard. This tool will allow you to create a shapes. So we need to create a shape which looks like a teardrop or leaf shape over the highlight above the cheekbone. You can adjust the size and shape of the selection by clicking and dragging the anchor points with the pen tool. This gives you the flexibility to create a selection that best suits your preference. And don't worry if you are not completely satisfied with your shape right away. You can always adjust it later on. Just take your time and make sure you are happy with the shape and size before moving on to the next step. Awesome. Now that you have created a teardrop shape, it's time to make a selection out of it. To do this, simply right click over the shape and select make selection and then hit OK. This will turn the shape you have created into a selection. Now that we have our selection, it's time to create a curves adjustment layer. When you create a curves adjustment layer with the selection active, it automatically loads the selection into the layer mask. This is a great feature because it allows us to make adjustments to the selected areas without affecting the rest of the image. To verify that our selection has been loaded into the layer mask, simply hold on the Alt key on your keyboard and click on the layer mask. You should be able to see the selection highlighted in white on the layer mask. Now that we have our selection loaded into the layer mask and our curves adjustment layer created, we can start making some adjustments to the image. Now we need to brighten the selected area. So click back into the layer thumbnail and then drag a point on the curve upwards. After making the brightness adjustments, we want to soften and feather the edges of our selection. To do this, click back into the layer mask, then go up to Filter, Blur, select Gaussian Blur. Select a value of about 30 pixels. This will help to soften and feather the edges of our selection, making it look more natural and seamless with the rest of the image. Be sure to adjust the value of the Gaussian Blur to your preference, as every image is different and may require a different value. Alright, let's move on to the next step. We are going to repeat the above mentioned steps, but this time we will target the shadows under the cheekbones. So create a shape again using the pen tool. Now make a selection, then add a curves adjustment layer, then drag a point downwards to darken this area. You can adjust the curve to your liking depending on how much shadow you want to add. Once you have adjusted the curve, it's time to blur the selection using Gaussian Blur. This helps to soften and feather our selection, giving it more natural and realistic look. Now let's move on to the jawline. Repeat the same steps we did for the cheekbone, but this time we want to brighten this area. So create a curves adjustment layer and then drag a point upwards to brighten the jawline. Again, adjust the curves to your liking. Once you have brightened the jawline, blur the selection using Gaussian Blur to soften and feather it. This will give a more natural look to the overall image. And there you have it. By repeating these steps, we have added depth and dimensions to our model's face, making image look more visually appealing and three-dimensional. And if you want, you can lower opacity of the any layer in the workspace to your preference. And here is before and after. You can see the difference it makes to the face and the overall image. This simple trick adds depth and dimensions to your model space and enhances the overall quality of the image. Thanks for watching this video on how to use a simple trick to add depth and dimensions to your model space. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest exclusive videos and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any future tips and tricks. See you again in the next video. Take care.